Sabbath is a day that the Lord made for you and me to rest in and praise the Creator. He made the heavens and the earth and the sea. He created all the living things that crawl the earth. He made the sun and the moon and the mountains, the visible and all that is visible. The Sabbath is a day where you and I have holy convocation and meet with believers. The Sabbath is a day made for man, so we rest from all our labors that make us weary. He made the heavens and the earth and the sea. He created all the living things that crawl the earth. He made the sun and the moon and the mountains, the visible and all that is invisible. Day one, let there be light. Day two,
he made the sky and the land.
Day three,
the trees, the flowers, and the grass.
Day four,
the stars and the moon and the sky.
Day five,
he made the fish and the birds.
Day six,
he made Adam and Eve.
Day seven, stop. He rested.
Seventh day,
he rested.
Holy day,
he rested.
The day of
he rested.
You and me.
Baruch haba, Basham, Yehovah, Almighty, the All-Strong. Yes, Father, just as you have said, if a child's hand is clean, he said he will eat with you. Hallelujah. And so you have given me a big, wide, large mouth to speak against, to ridicule one most powerful angel you created, Lucifer, alias aka Jesus the Allah. You gave me your right hand fellowship to walk upon Satan's once crowned head. Devil, your once glory turned shame. Your once sweet anointed voice turned bitterness, curses, sorrow. Your once beauty turned eternal ugliness in the lake of fire. For you were once full of wisdom, but now you are full of feces, garbage, good for nothing. For you were once full of light, but now you are full of darkness. For you were once full of joy, eternal joy in his presence. Devil, but now you are full of sorrow, sadness for all eternity. For you were once in the mountain of Yahuwah, fire, the mountain of fire of Yahuwah in the Eden's garden. But now where are you? In the eternal lake of fire. For you were once made fire of fires. But that same fire, Satan the devil, will roast you. It will roast you for all eternity in the place called the lake of fire. Yes, you are being rewarded according to your deeds. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. For you are righteous and your judgment you pronounce upon this great high lord, the devil, it is a righteous judgment. To the Abba Yehovah, Almighty Elohim, Basham, Yehoshua, HaMashiach, hallelujah, amen. Greetings to the 12 tribes of Yisrael scattered in the four corners of the earth, and to the Gentiles called by the name of Yahuwah. Shalom and much love, family. For you are the reason of our timeline truth, because the time is near. Just as we see the days goes by, and so draw nigh the coming of our Messiah, the very one we have been waiting for. Just as the Malach of Yehovah said unto Yehukanai the Revelator, sealed not the prophecies of this book, for the time is near. Exactly what we are doing here, family. Decoding end times prophecies, signs, dreams, in preparing people, house, body for the returning of King Yehoshua HaMashiach, our eternal bridegroom, to whom due all praises, worship, honor, power, riches, exaltation eternally, to the glory of his magnificent Father, Yehovah the Almighty and the All Strong. Hallelujah. Family, we are here today to expose the highest mass grave of Christianity lies. That as we dig down the root of this mass grave of Christianity lies, every victim, like I once was, all the elect in this mass grave will ascend into the eternal love of Yahuwah. And this is the only reason and purpose for this very message. We are out for the elect. Just, this is how we always do it. As we are being told by the royal law that we should preset upon preset. They said we must do it preset upon preset, and we must line it up with lines upon lines, and we must take here a little from Genesis, and we must take there a little from Revelation to establish every saints of Yahuwah. So this is how we are being told, and this is how we do it. Today's topic, it is Christianity, spiritual and physical witchcraft. Like I said, they have two kinds of witchcraft. And we are going to look into their physical witchcraft and their spiritual witchcraft, how it operates. And after we have done with this, look into their physical witchcraft, and we will also proceed to see how they are initiating people. Because in any kingdom of witchcraft, of course, they always initiate people into their coven. And we're also looking to it, how they are initiating people into this their witchcraft coven. And then we will proceed to look into their spiritual witchcraft. First, as the royal law said, sin is breaking the law of Yahuwah. Now, I will throw a question before we proceed. How many sin did the devil sin before Father Yahuwah cast him out, now prepared for the eternal link of fire? Only once, when he rejects the law of Yahuwah, when he refused to keep the law of Yahuwah and accept his own law, therefore Father Yahuwah now cast him out to the lowest pit right now as we are talking. Now, how many sin did the first man Adam Kawa sin in Genesis 3? Before Father Yahuwah rejected and also cast them out of the Garden of Eden in his presence and brought about this great destruction upon humanity today, only once, as they refused the law of Yahuwah and keep the laws of the devil, he rejected them. Now, in the same form, how many sins did the man, first man and the first woman sin, that brought down he that knew no sin to come and put on his head now a crown of sin for you and me? Only once sinned, the first man and the first woman, that brought about the crucifixion of Messiah. For you to know how much Father Yahuwah hates sin. He hated sin. He cannot compromise when it comes to sin. Only one sin these two people did, a holy one has to come down from heaven to die. Now, another question. How many times did Judas Iscariot betray a Messiah that make Messiah to lay a curse on him? Just once. He betrayed him only once when he went away and to do the will of the devil. As the devil entered him, he betrayed a holy one to the hands of a sinful man. And King Yehoshua now said, it would have been better, you will never be born, than to betray the Son of the Most High into the hands of sinners. You see, Judas also did it just once, and therefore he got a cox. That was why he burst on the street as he was being hanged on the tree. He burst on the street. All his tester came out. He only did that one week, that weekend, just once. You see, so it don't take you to live in a sin or keep repeating one thing before Father Yehovah will discreate you. He searches the heart. If your heart is made up to keep living lawlessness, therefore he will discreate you. Now, from the royal law, 1 Samuel chapter 15, we are going to look now into physical witchcraft of Christianity. Like all this video I'm putting, later I will talk about that. All these are that I resurrect. They are the witchcraft. We will talk about that later. We are going to take it step by step. Now, their first witchcraft, physical witchcraft, is found in 1 Samuel chapter 15. I will read from 22 to 23, but it will be better if you can go through all so that you understand where we are going. Now, he said, because here, let me just brief it. This is about the first dynasty of King Saul. Father Yehovah asked him to go and destroy all the Amalek. However, when he got there, he only did this wickedness also once. He rewrites history. The people Father Yehovah asked him to destroy, he found himself doing his own will and reject the law of Yehovah. He's allowed the king Agagai to live. And Father Yehovah knew that Agagai, Amalek, they were not good at all for his people. That was why he wanted to wipe them out of the land of the living. But however, as King Saul went into battle, he spared him when he felt like. He added his own law, his own will. He rejected that of Almighty Yehovah and let the very Iroko tree King Agagai to live. And from there we now see this wickedness now proceed, whereby Father Yehovah says, suffer not a witch for a living. King Saul now suffer Agagai the Amalek for a living to keep tormenting the children of Israel. And we see this very wickedness proceed now, because he led their Iroko tree to live. There come now the offspring, the very Emma, the Agagite. You can find this account from the book of Adasa chapter 3 to chapter 9, the one you call Esther. We see Haman now paid such a huge amount to wipe out. That was the genocide he wanted to remove every single Jew in the land to the grave, until Father Yehovah himself now intervened and rescued his people. So this wickedness came from this particular place I'm quoting now. I just brief it. So Father Yehovah said, don't suffer them for a living. However, King Saul do his own thing and reject that of Almighty Yehovah. And he did this wickedness only once. And therefore, Father Yehovah now discredited him. So I read verses 22. And Samuel said, has Yehovah has great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices as in obeying the voice of Yehovah? Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to hearken than the fat of rams. You see, King Saul was saying, no, we spare these people, we spare some, we keep some to just to make sacrifice to you. And Father Yehovah is not delight in those nonsense. What he delighted is for you to just obey what he said. His voice there also makes his word. Now, verses 23, he said, for rebellion, listen, now here is our message. For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft. He said rebellion, to rebel against Yehovah is witchcraft. And stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry. Because thou hast rejected the word of Yehovah, he has also rejected thee from being a king. You see? First, we will start with the word of Yehovah, because King Saul rejected the word of Yehovah. Who is the word of Yehovah? Yehovah cannot give us this answer. From the royal law, John chapter 1, verses 14. He said, the word of Yehovah now became flesh and dwells amongst us. King Yehoshua, he is the word of Almighty Yehovah. And we found it
in everywhere from the scripture that Father Yehovah created every single thing in heaven on earth, visible and invisible, kingdoms, authority, dominion, every single thing you can ever see. He created it by his word. And his word is King Yehoshua HaMashiach. He said, because you have rejected his word, therefore, he has also rejected you. So the word he rejected is Messiah himself. Now, witchcraft, this particular place I just quoted, is first time for us to see, witchcraft. In every other places before this very particular passage, he always called witch. So what is craft? Now it is double. You are not just a witch, but there is a craft being added unto you. And where did we get this word craft? Right in Genesis 3. Father Yehovah said, devil, the serpent, is the most crafty of all the beasts of the field. He is the most crafty. You see, the word craft came from the devil. He is the craft. And you being disobey the things of Almighty Yehovah, therefore you now become a witchcraft. Double together. The craft there is the devil, which sits on your head to be a witch, which means to be breaking the laws of Yehovah. Then we see the witchcraft now. Let's proceed. He said, your sin, rebellion, rebel, that is carrying out your own will, it is a sin of witchcraft. Now, here is a question. This is how Christianity is doing it. On a normal basis, outside the things of the royal law, go to Christianity and ask them, what do you understand? What did you understand by forever? Our Christianity will answer you so correctly. Forever simply means forever, forever. They will answer with all their heart. Forever means forever. Absolute. It means forever. Whereby Father Yehovah said, keeping of Shabbat, it is forever. It is perpetual covenant. When you now draw the attention to this, Christians say, okay, oh, that one. No, that forever, that doesn't really mean forever. It means that forever ends at the cross. There the forever ends. It doesn't really mean forever when it comes to the things of... You see, they are always against the things of Almighty. Outside the things of Almighty, forever is forever before the... But when you now come to the things of Almighty, they will say, no, however, that forever, it doesn't really mean forever. It ends at the cross. Now, when you go to Christianity, outside the things of Yehovah, just ask them, what is forever? Again, they will answer you so accurately. Forever simply means forever. With all their heart, they will answer correctly. Whereby Father Yehovah said, keeping of his feast, it is forever. So when you now bring that to their attention, they will say, oh, cool. And that one, it doesn't really have to do with forever. You know, this feast was the ordinances that was against us. It was the thing that was contrary against our soul. And that was why Jesus took it away and nailed it to the cross. You see? So that forever, when it comes to the things of Yehovah, it doesn't mean forever. It ends at the cross. Okay? Again, as Christianity, what did you understand by forever? With all their teeth, without, they will say, it is forever. Yeah, but when you not take... draw their attention to the things of Yehovah, that Father Yehovah said, this is my name forever. This is the name I will be called by all generations. Yehovah, I am that I am. This is my memorial name. This is the only name that went into battle and redeemed his people. When you not draw the attention to this, they will say, oh no, you can call him by any name. His name is God. It doesn't matter. He knew. He simply knew I'm talking to him. Let me give this simple illustration. You now, as a person that is having a party, and you invited about 30 kings into your party. 30 kings in this your banquet. And meanwhile, you would like to also have interview with all these 30 kings. That as soon as you come into your position as the host, you took now your microphone. Now you want to address the king. You will say, king, all of them will stare at you. because they are all kings. All these 30 personality, they are all kings. They will stare at you right away because they are king. All 30 at once. For you not to make a distinction, you must call that king by his name. You must make mention of his name before the other 29 will not understand. Okay, we are not the one he's talking about. You see, God, everything is God. Snake is being worshipped as God. Snake is God. Iron is God. Stone is God. Tree is God. Wood is God. We are seeing only all these things. Crocodile. Huh? We are seeing all this. Even a cow is being worshipped as gods. Even the Bible says, you and me, we are gods. Everything is God. Devil is the god of this world that blinded the eyes of men never to see the true light of the gospel. Everything is God. We see that. Even star, moon, a sun. People is worshipping them as gods. So now when you are praying to God, if you said, well, I differentiate my own by calling him father. No, devil is also a father. He said, you are of your father, the devil. You see, devil has children. Devil is also a father. Where they also say, we also make a distinction by calling him almighty God. No, the royal law also said the same thing. You are serving another mighty one. You see, so this is the physical witchcraft of Christianity. They are always waging war against the real thing. Again, when you come to Christianity, ask them, how long, what is singular? They will simply make it so clear to you, singular is just one thing. You can't multiply singular. Singular simply means single thing. Whereby when you now draw the attention to the holy things of Yahuwah that seeth only one name, there is no salvation in any other name but this one name that is being given unto man under this heaven, whereby you must be saved. Oh, Christianity will say, oh, not that again. You can call him anything. You can call him any name. He knew I'm talking about him. He knew I'm calling unto him. You can call him Jesus, you can call him Jesus, you can call him Isus, it doesn't matter. No, that of the Jesus, they will disagree because they know that is where the OT came from. They will not accept that. That one, they will understand that is the devil. But when you now say Isus, Isus, they would say, yes, that is his name because Jesus came from Isus, Isus. You can call him Jesus. This is names. This is not singular anymore. This is a name that is being multiplied, derived from a place to a place. You see, this is the physical witchcraft of Christianity. That is somehow, if you are worthy of salvation, you will quick understand this. This is their witchcraft. So now let us proceed now how they initiate people. Because it says stubbornness is a sin of iniquity and idolatry. What is stubbornness? Just like Christianity today, we have been saying all these things. Shabbat is the day. We have been giving them. We have been pointing them to the real thing of Almighty Yahuwah. But they will not listen to us. They are so stubborn that even though they knew Christmas is not the day of Messiah's birth, they will say, however, many of them knew it. They will say, however, it doesn't matter. We are worshiping. I'm just celebrating the birthday of Messiah. You see, I'm just celebrating his birthday. This Linda is their mother of this very witchcraft. I'm coming right back to this. I want to cut your attention to this so that when I keep talking about them, you will understand what I'm talking about. That is why I use that. They are the very message of this. They are the very picture of this message. You see, they will keep keeping Christmas, even though Christmas is not there. Bible condemns it. Even January 1st is not found. All these, their demonic feast, nowhere is being found. They will keep that is stubbornness. However, I knew it was not birth. Can you put your child on a manger on December 25th and put him on the street? No one does that. It is a very cold period of time. They knew it. They would say, however, it doesn't matter. We are just celebrating his birthday. Even though this birthday belongs to the pagan's birthday, it doesn't matter. We are just celebrating our Messiah. Our Messiah, no, we are honoring him these days.
Even though the illustration of Major is simply making note to us that the birthday of Messiah, it was on the Feast of Tabernacle. That was the day everybody has to build a tabernacle to dwell in this great, in this 8 days long feast. They sleeps outside. They build a tabernacle. And Messiah being the one to fulfill the law, that was why he was also being birthed and be put in this very season of the Feast of Tabernacle, the first day of it, and be put also in this Sukkot. That manger is Sukkot. Messiah, that was why they also put Messiah in the manger, in the Sukkot. He was being birthed on the Feast of Tabernacle. That is his birthday, September. You see, Christianity will keep persisting in wickedness. That is the stubborn. And this stubbornness, that is where Messiah now conclude that their judgment. From this, their stubbornness, that is where they now initiate people into their coven. Stubbornness in lies. Stubbornness to keep living lawlessness. What is iniquity? Iniquity simply means living lawlessness. And what is idolatry? Idolatry means simply you are worshiping another mighty one. And these two attitude came from your stubbornness. And when you are being stubborn like this, this is where they initiate people into their coven.
From the royal law, Galatians chapter 3, verses 1, Apostle Shehu said,
"Oh, foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you that you do not obey the truth of Messiah? And still keeping the works of the law, and still doing the works of the law." He was rebuking them there because they were still doing the sacrificial law. And Messiah was the perfect Passover lamb. That you need to look up to perfect Passover lamb, not for you to still do your sacrificial law. He said, "Who has bewitched you?" This is Christianity that they will bewitch, that when you are being bewitched, you will never keep to the real thing of Almighty Yahuwah, who is the truth. Messiah said, "I'm the way and I am the truth." That they will never allow you to keep to the truth of Almighty Yahuwah, rather to be keeping on the counterfeit. That if they bewitch you, then you are going to be seeing the counterfeit as the truth. Let's get that from the account of Simeon. Acts of Apostles chapter 8 from verses 9 to 11, I read. This is how they are bewitching you. He said, "But there was a certain man called Simeon, which before time in the same city," the city of Samaria, "in the same city used sorcery and bewitched the people of Samaria, giving out that then himself was someone great." He used sorcery to bewitch them, to whom they all gave heed, from the least to the greatest, saying, "This man is the great power of God." You see, they were not awarded the power of the Most High to this very wizard who was bewitching them, that they were never seeing that power as a witch power, but rather they were not seeing that as the power of the Most High. And to him they had regard, because that of long time he had bewitched them with sorcery. You see, they never said that it was a sorcery. They were only saying that this is the power, this is the divine power, the power of the Most High. That when they have not bewitched you, you begin to see things, lies as truth, demons as angel. This is the bewitching. This is how they are initiating you into their coven. That even though now when you read the law, the royal law, that King Yehoshua said, "Think not that I've come to do away with the law, nor the prophet, until every single thing is fulfilled." The sign for every single thing to be fulfilled, it is for this heaven and this earth to pass out. That you will not see like that anymore. You will begin to take it now in another dimension. And first of all, let's see how this witchcraft, this wizard, the devil bewitched the first man and the first woman. What happened? In Genesis chapter 3, that when devil come, he never said that Father Yahuwah is lying. First, he inquired of the woman, he approached the woman and inquired. Did the Most High say you shouldn't do a thing like this or a thing like that? She said, "Yes, actually the Most High says so, that the devil will eat of this tree, will die, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil." What did the devil do? He twisted it in their hand and said no in her hands and said no, it was that actually that is not what he meant. He meant that the day you will eat of it, you will become wise. You will be like the Most High, knowing good and evil.
So as soon as the woman heard of this, he twisted that this sign of Yahuwah in her hand. Therefore, she now go for it. That is the initiation. Devil now initiates that woman into him, the eternal link of fire. You see, this is how they are initiating people, turning the scripture outside that into the mass grave of the devil. Prophet Yeshua, who said, hell is being enlarged every now and then. So we are going to see how hell is being enlarged. This is the mass grave of Christianity. Through the power of their witchcraft, initiated people into the cover of Jesus the Jesus. Now from the royal law, Revelation chapter 2. Says King Yehoshua himself, he said, nevertheless, I hold from 20, you can read all if you will. I read from 20. He said, nevertheless, I hold this against you because you suffer that woman Jezebel, which call herself prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed to idols. Did you hear that? You suffer, whereby the royal law says, suffer not a witchcraft for a living. You suffer this woman for a living, who call herself prophetess, that is teaching and seducing the people of the Most High to eat. Is seducing into fornication. What is fornication? Having sex. That now, when you expose yourself, a man and a woman expose, they see each other nakedness. That is the deep things of the devil. That you see the nakedness of the devil. That devil also see your nakedness. That you are seeing the nakedness of the devil as an angel, as paradise. But devil, meanwhile, you are seeing the link of fire. But devil knew the written about you. He is seeing that at the end of it all, you are going to rust in hell with him. But you are seeing the nakedness of the devil like that of an angel. You expose yourself to one another, you seduce them. Christianity, this woman here, in biblical term, women always represent a ministry, the congregation. This woman here, Jezebel, she is the Christianity. I will prove that in a very open way. You see, is the servant of the Most High. This is the people we are looking for. This is the people we are, because of them, always talk every now and then. Because as for the Christianity, they won't repent, never. And I gave her, this is Messiah verse 21, say, and I gave her long space to repent from her fornication. And she was not willing to repent. And she didn't repent. She refused to repent. You see, this witchcraft, it will proceed to stubbornness. And this woman, this is the stubbornness of this woman. No matter how you will preach to her, no matter how you will try to point the right thing to her, she will not repent. Messiah now conclude that case. What Messiah is going to do to her? He said, behold, I will cast her in the bed of affliction. This bed of affliction means you are going to lay, this devil you already lay with in fornication, you are going to lay with him eternally in the lake of fire. That is the bed of affliction. He said, I will cast her. This is the judgment of Christianity, the great prostitute, because they are not going to change. Never. Never. Because now they are stubborn in their wickedness, in their witchcraft. Their witchcraft proceed to stubbornness. They will never repent. And as they are not going to repent, they are going out to be preaching more wickedness to bring people into the coven of the devil, initiation. Witchcraft, initiate them into witchcraft. He said, and them that commit adultery with her, I will cast them into great tribulation, except they repent of their deeds. You see, this is the people we are looking for. These people, however, the people that commit this adultery with this Christendom, which is the choosing, the people of the Most High, the servant. However, there is ability for these people to repent. And this is the people we are reaching out to. And this is the people we are in need of. This is the people we want to reach to through this message. We talk for the reason of these people. He said, except they repent, because he put a demarcation that except the people that commit adultery. What is adultery? Adultery simply means you are a married woman, you now want to go and have sex with another man. These people here are the bride of Messiah. They are the wife of Messiah. Now, Christianity is initiated into another mighty one, another deity, the very Jesus. And by so doing, they are committing adultery. They are keeping Sunday instead of keeping Shabbat. They are keeping the rules and regulation of another deity instead of keeping that of their husband. That is why, in us, he said, the people that commit adultery with her.
These are the people of God. These are the people we are in need of. We don't need Christianity for any reason. Nothing. Because their case is judged already. Now, Messiah said, except they repent. And let us see verse 23. He now said, I will kill all her children. You see, Messiah said he's going to slaughter all the children of Christianity. All her children here simply means the Gentiles that hold on to this teaching. They are the East children. You see, these three personality, Christianity is not going to repent. All their children, which means the people that believe in this, their wickedness is not going to repent. But the servant of the Most High, whom they seduce to fornicate with the devil, those who, however, they have the ability to repent. Those are the people we are in search of. And we speak for the reason of these people. You see, this is their wickedness. This is how they initiate people now into the coven of the devil. He said, all the congregation shall know that I am he which searcheth the hearts and the mind, and I will give to everyone according to your deeds. This is him. He said when he come, he is going to reward every single one according to your deeds. Let also proceed further and see how this Christendom is initiating the whole world, the almost third part of the whole world, into the coven of Jesus, into the coven, into the witchcraft. Bring them in to be a witch, a witchcraft. Now, Revelation 17, verses 1. I read, and there come one of the seven angels, which are the seven vows, and talked with me and say unto me, come hither, I will show unto you the judgment of this great prostitute that sit upon many waters. You see, they sit upon, because their stubbornness led them to sit upon many waters in the whole world now, to lead them into this witchcraft coven. This is their mass grave. And verses 2, he said, with whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth have made drunk with the wine of our fornication. They all got drunk with the lies of Christianity. So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness, and I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet a colored beast full of names. You see, Christianity said doesn't matter, they have a lot of names, whereby only one name is given under this, and whereby you must be saved. But this beast full of names of blasphemy, having seven heads and 10 horns, and the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having golden cup in her hand full of abomination and filthiness of her fornication. And upon her forehead was a written name called Mystery. We will get back to this mystery now. Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and the abomination of the earth. Do you see? All that they are doing is the abomination of the earth, the mother. Do you see mother and children in chapter 2, Revelation 2? He said, all our children I will kill. And they are the mother of this prostitute, this the evangelist. This is the evangelist, their pastor, their prophet. All this title they gave to themselves in the four corners of the earth. He said the wrath of this woman is fornication. It gets the whole world in prostitution. With the wine of her fornication. This is the Christendom, people. This is Christianity. Now in chapter 18, this is their judgment. This is the judgment of this great island. After these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lighted with his glory. And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the Great is folly, and he's become the habitat of devils and the hold of every foul spirit and a cage of every unclean and hateful bird. For all nations have drunk of the wine of our wrath, of our fornication. This, the wrath of Christianity, is fornication. They have got drunk, the whole nation, the whole earth. And the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her. And the mansions of the earth are was rich through her abundance of her riches. You see, and I heard another voice from heaven say, come out of her, my people, that ye be not a partaker of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues. For her sins have reached in unto heaven, and Yahuwah has remembered her iniquity. What did the royal law say? Stubbornness is a sin of iniquity and of idolatry. Idolatry, worshiping another deity. And Messiah said, he commit myself to fornicate, into fornication and into idolatry. This is how Christianity defied the OF. And he said the OF has become rich through this very wickedness. Do you see how rich their pastor are? Do you see how, well, especially one that just started his ministry, what did they call him? They called him a prophet. What did they call Prophet Major One from South Africa? Major One from South Africa. He only started his ministry only 7 years now, 2009. Today is the richest black pastor, worth over 150 million. Really? Tell me what kind of business you would do under 7 years. Just 7 years, they will become this rich, wealthy. Do you see all their pastors having all kinds of houses in the four corner of the earth that became rich through the wickedness of this, their evil message, the Christendom, their mother, the very Jesus, the Jesus. So this is how they deceive the whole world. Now, this particular passage said mystery. There is a name on their forehead, is a mystery. And Apostle Shaul said also from the royal law, this is what we are going to look into. We are looking into how they are initiating people into this, their mass grave. A pastor here said to me that they always call him God. I will use your language for you. God sent him into Netherlands to come and build a church. And I said, I'm tired of this, your God, that always send you to where peace is. Why can't this your God send you to Saudi Arabia and go and build church over there? This your God always send you to where peace is. Saudi Arabia, there is not even one church. You don't talk about Jesus there. That will cut off your head. Why can't this your God send you over there? You see, because he want to become rich, because they have seen and they have discovered how to get rich fast for it is through this pastors becoming prophets, talking nonsense, doing iniquity. You see, he said, Apostle Shaul said in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 7, he said the mystery of iniquity is already at work. You see, this iniquity that they are doing is a mystery. And the name on their forehead is a mystery. And to us, we know that name is Jesus. Because on our forehead, we see it in Revelation 14. It said the forehead of the elect, and we see the seal took place in Revelation 7. And 14, we see the seal on their forehead was the name of Yahuwah, Yahuwah Yahushua. It said the name of the Father and the name of the Son on the forehead of the elect, of the chosen. And we also see the name of the forehead of on the forehead of this woman is a mystery. Jesus can never go with Yahuwah. No, Jesus is a bastard. Don't have a father. Yahushua have. That was why he said, I call me my father's name. His father's name is Yahuwah. Yahuwah Yahushua. That is the name on our forehead. But in the forehead of Christianity, it is Jesus on their forehead. You see, the name on their forehead, it is a mystery. And the way they are doing this iniquity is also a mystery. You will be thinking they are working miracle, but there is a Apostle Shaul said the mystery of the iniquity is already at work. And we will know, we will see who is this lawless one that is doing this iniquity miracle. From the royal law, Messiah said, Matthew 7 verses 21 to 20, 26 or 7, he said, many of you is going to say that day, Adonai, Adonai, we prophesy, we cast out demons, we do many miracles in your name. Messiah will say, oh no, sorry, I wasn't the one. I wasn't. He will point you now to the one who do this mystery iniquity in you. He will point you to the one whom you gave yourself to serve. He said he's going to point you to them. He'll say, that wasn't me. You workers of iniquity, the miracle, the prophecies, the great signs you did, it came from the bottomless pit, from your witchcraft power.
the witchcraft power Jesus used to turn the whole things upside down. That is the power that worked with you. I never knew you. I never knew because you wasn't my bride. I only knew my bride. And your bridegroom knew you. He pregnanted you. And you brought forth these children miracle, these children miracle for your husband. I wasn't your husband. I never knew you. Adam knew his wife. His wife now brought forth children for him. But I never knew you. I wasn't the one who knew you. It was your bridegroom who knew you. And that is the one you brought for this miracle, prophecy, casting out demons and wonders for, not me. And he said he will cast them into the outer darkness. Therefore, he will send you, because devil is darkness, he will send you now to your bridegroom, which is the very devil. This is the mystery of iniquity. That this iniquity is a mystery. You don't understand it.
Now, Apostle Shahu said in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, you can read from verses 1 to 12, but for the sake of time, I'm going to read, just pick some places I want to make up my state. He said, let no man deceive you. This is verse 3. Deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come, except there come a fall away first. He said, a man is going to fall away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. Who is, what is sin? Meaning breaking the laws of Yahuwah. He said, until this man of sin will reveal himself, who oppose and exalt himself above all things that is called Yahuwah, or that is called worship, so that he as Elohim sits in the temple of Yahuwah, show himself that he is the Elohim. You see, then I proceed to 7. It said, for the mystery of iniquity doeth at work already. Only he who that is talking about the Holy Spirit here. You see, said the iniquity, the mystery of iniquity is already at work, even in their old days, is already at work. Now I read from 8 now. It said, and then shall that wicked be revealed, whom Adonai shall consume with the spirit of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming, whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness. You see, in them that perish, because they received not the love of Yahuwah in truth, that they might be saved. We will come back here again. You see, so this is the mystery of iniquity. The name is mystery, and the wonders is lying, is with all deceivable, is a mystery. Only on that day when Messiah comes, because he already said to your judgment that he is going to reject you to your face and said, I never knew you. Only that you are going to know this nonsense, all this Suleiman, and all this TB Joshua Beni, Christachinome, Oyedikpo, whatever they call them. Then you are going to know that all these things you people do, it was iniquity, mystery. Only on this day it's going to be exposed to you. So now let's look into their spiritual witchcraft. This is their highest wickedness in the spirit realm. This is their most devilish place. I die. I resurrect. Jesus say, I see demon. I enter into the bottomless pit. I come out. There was a great torment there. And now I ascend again. Jesus carried me to heaven. And now I come down again. To this, Jesus said, I should tell you not to do this and not to do that. This is witchcraft. Wickedness in the highest place. This is the most wickedness of Satan in the highest place. Oh, that was why he's called it mystery iniquity. Oh, my Father, this, let's see where the spirit also came from. Because the sins of stubbornness, after you've been a witchcraft, you proceed now to stubbornness. Exactly what the first dynasty did. When he have not sinned, Father Yahweh rejected him, he proceed to stubbornness. Because his heart is already be hardened, he can never repent. Now, let's see the author of the witchcraft. The very thing we are seeing in the Christendom today is so scary. Now, from the royal law of 1 Samuel chapter 28, I read from verses 25. You can read all to get the understanding very well. I start from 5. And when Saul saw that the host of the Philistines was Philistine, he was afraid, and his heart greatly troubled. And when Saul inquired of Yehovah, because Yehovah already rejected him, of course, inquired of Yehovah, Yehovah answered him not, neither by dreams, not by Urim, nor by prophets. There said Saul unto his servant, seek me a woman with a witch spirit. A witch spirit, familiar spirit, that I may go to her and inquire of her. And his servant said to him, behold, there was a woman that had a witchcraft spirit at Edom. Therefore, Saul has to disguise himself and now goes to this woman to inquire. And he now said unto this woman, I want to move fast, but for the sake of time, you can read all. He now said unto this woman, okay, verses 9. And the woman said, as he said unto this woman to consult the spirit of the dead for him, and the woman has said unto him, behold, thou knowest what Saul has done, how he cut off all the familiar spirits and the wizards of the land. Wherefore layest thou a snare for my life to cast me to die? Then Saul now said, I swear to her, by the, you see, he was still carrying the name of Yehovah unto this place, by the name of Yehovah, saying, as Yehovah liveth, there shall be no punishment happen to you. Therefore, the woman now said, whom shall I bring up for you? And Saul now said, bring me up Samuel. And the woman now saw Samuel, as she invoked the power of witchcraft. She now saw Samuel. Are you not telling me now, a witchcraft woman, a witch or a wizard, resurrecting a holy prophet of Yehovah? Of course not. She invoked that spirit because Samuel was already at the bosom of Father Abraham. Because that is the very place, Father, you were prepared for the Old Testament until Messiah comes. On the resurrection day, we are going to talk more about the bosom of Abraham. So, spirit is already there. Only the flesh is useless now because the flesh counts for nothing. And this woman, a resurrected demon, to took up now the form of a prophet Simon. And this demon now beginning to confirm a holy message of prophet Simon, the message he once gave to a soul. This demon that he said this demon looked like a ghost that rose from the bottomless pit. He now began to confirm this very message prophet Samuel once gave unto Saul as he sinned. He confirmed that message. And this is the wickedness we are seeing in Christianity today. That Christianity, we said they died, they resurrected. This is the thousands of it in the YouTube. They say Jesus. Jesus said, don't wear trousers. Jesus said, don't make up. Don't put on weave on. Don't rub makeup. Don't use perfume. Don't use odorant. Really? Jesus is resurrecting demons to come and be confirming a holy scripture that is being given unto us. This is their spiritual witchcraft, people. We got this information right from this particular place because witchcraft proceeds to stubbornness and stubbornness proceeds to iniquity. And Apostle Shaul said, the worker, the mystery of the iniquities is it is already at work. It's a mystery, people. That this demon now begin to confirm the holy message of Prophet Samuel. He said today, tomorrow you and your son is going to die. You see, exactly the same thing we are hearing from Christianity, that they heard a voice, like the Linda is the mother of them all. He said she heard a voice, while Daniel is the mother, is the father of them all. He said she heard a voice and said, tomorrow you are going to die. Like the Angelica, like the Margaret, they always hear this voice that they are going to die. That Christianity, with the Apostle Shehu said, if it is we or another angel from heaven come with another gospel, he said, let him be eternally condemned. That these people, when they resurrected, they are not coming to even give us the criteria of holiness standard of the Bible. They will come with another thing entirely. That you shouldn't wear trousers. Really? Is that the holiness the Bible gave unto us? Is that the criteria of entering into heaven? Is that the sin that will take you to hell? This is not the same Messiah told us, neither all the prophets, nor the apostles. They gave us The sin, and the sin that will make you not to enter heaven, it is to keep another man's doctrine. It is to break the royal law. The very one Christianity is breaking today. That is the sin. He said, because you have rejected my word, as he said to Saul, he said, therefore Yahweh also rejected you. The only thing that will make Yahweh to reject you not to enter heaven, it is you breaking his laws. And we gave this criteria that would disqualify us not to go into heaven. We found it from Messiah, from Apostle Shaul, or the prophet. Number one, it is this very witchcraft of Christianity. And we found the standard of righteousness. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, Galatians chapter 5, verses 16 to 21, Revelation 22, 21. We see all the criteria. That if you do any of these things, you will not enter heaven. The one Christian though is bringing from the pit of hell, a teaches of demon, is never be found. That when you make up, you go to hell. That when you wear trousers, you go to hell. That if you don't pay tithe, you go to hell. Really? Where is it in the royal law that you have to pay tithe with money? That if you don't sow seed, you go to hell. Really? Where is it from the royal law that you have to sow a seed with money? One of them said, that Jesus also said they should keep Sunday holy. Really? Where is it be satisfied Sunday in the royal law? This is the testimony of Jesus. The very one we find from the witches of Edo. The very one they are ministering today. This is their most wickedness. Now, let's go into it. Linda gave a testimony, very wicked testimony. The same with this demon also. This was the very one that defiled me. This was the very one that used to pollute my life. He's called himself Danny. He says he's a pastor. Now, what happened? Linda gave a very wicked testimony also with this Daniel, Angelica. All their testimony is satanism from the is a teaching of demons. Because the royal law make it so clear, in these last days, many is going to turn away from the faith. They won't give ear to sound doctrine anymore. They are going to give their ears to the teachings of demons, not to that of Yahuwah anymore. That now, Lidana said she was a prostitute even before she died. She never repented. That as soon as she died, she was being cast into the bottomless pit. That as soon as she entered into the bottomless pit, demon with great horns, like they are illustrating in this video, took a very big rod and put it on the fire, that the rod was so reddish, so hot, that demon now inserted it on her private part. That she was crying and shouting, she was in a great torment. He said this is how they torment them over there. A prostitute, that is how a prostitute is being tormented. Now, a person that make up, he said they will pour acid on your face that to clean that makeup from your face. He said that is how they torture that person. Now, a person that is drinking alcohol, he said the demon will piss, it will urinate and give you that urine to drink. That is how they are being tormented. Now, the person that bleach, he said the demon will just plug iron and it will just use it to iron your body. That is how they torment that person that bleached. And the person that also fix high lashes, they will just take a sharp object to shook your eyebrow. That is how they torment them. He said the person that also fix weaving, they will just take a sharp object. That, he said they will scrape even your scarf now. They are not only going to pull out that weaver, they will use that sharp object to scrape your weaver. He said that was how they are being tormented. When you enter into hell, Christianity, you will never come out. The royal law make it so clear. You will never come out. This vision was being given by Messiah himself. Shut up your mouth and stop deceiving us. Go away from us with your witchcraft. That when the vision of Lazarus and the rich man, that the rich man died, Lazarus died, he was being carried to the bosom of Father Abraham. On resurrection day, we will talk more about this bosom of Abraham. It's another part in hell. It's like this earth, but under the earth is no hell. Is higher than the bottomless pit, of course. That is where the people of the Most High await Messiah to come. That when this man was there, Lazarus, he was being carried to the bosom of Abraham. He was being comforted over there. That as soon as the rich man died, he was being buried in hell. And this is the message Christianity is passing us to us today. the message of the rich man from the bottomless pit, from hell, that this rich man now said unto Father Abraham, however, by the craftiness of Jesus, he allowed this rich man to see the bosom of Father Abraham, to see Lazarus. Due to the torment he was going through, he now asked Father Abraham, please, tell Lazarus to dip his hand in the cold water and send him down to me in hell to cool my tongue. Father Abraham said, that is never been done. There is a great gulf, feast. This is feast, great gulf. For you not to come to us, he said, there is a great gulf, feast, that we can never cross over to you, that you can never cross over to us. This is the great gulf. You can't pass to us, we can't pass to you. When you enter into the bottomless pit, it is gone forever. You are only be there for a appointed time to ascend now on the day of resurrection to face the judgment white throne. That is the place of a transit. You are waiting your final judgment day. A prophet Daniel speak about this. The resurrection of the wicked is to face the judgment white throne. Yehoshaphat also said the same thing. And Messiah also said the same thing. And Father Abraham also, from this vision of Messiah, gave unto us. When you enter there, you don't resurrect. You are there to face the white judgment throne. He said, no, it has never been possible. He now said, okay, no problem. Please, can you send Lazarus to go and tell to go to my father's house? I have five brothers, to tell them not to come here. Father Abraham said, that is never been done. They have the law and no shame. So let them listen to the law. Because it was basically what Father Abraham was saying. You cannot bring demon. Because Father Yehovah said, oh my father, demon cannot teach the living. The deaf cannot teach the living. Father Abraham was just saying to wickedness, persistence of this rich man, that it is never been done. Someone cannot come here to go and be teaching the people that is alive and said, this is how hellfire look like. No. The hellfire is already been described from the royal law, by the prophet, by the apostles. And King Yehoshua is the one telling us this vision, what is going to be happening. Because he knew devil would come in his craftiness to use this to deceive the elect. That is why he first of all gave us this warning. That has never been done. Father Abraham said, no way. I cannot send nobody from here to the earth to preach message. From the bottomless pit, he said, no, they have the prophet and they have the law. Let them listen to them. And the man that persists in his wickedness, I said, no, if somebody come from the grave, they will believe it. That is more authentic. Father Abraham said, that is not true. It is not true at all. He said, come, if they don't believe the law and they don't believe the prophet, what make you think that they are also going to believe that someone resurrected from the dead? Because the law is more authentic. The prophet is more authentic. It is powerful that when you study the law, you understand what hellfire is all about. When you study the account of the prophet, you understand what hellfire is all about. Not for you to come here to go and be teaching people. No, that has never been done. So Messiah make it so clear to us that it is not possible. But Christianity today is telling us that it is possible. When you enter hell, that is the end. You can never resurrect to life. You will only resurrect on the judgment day. It is appointed unto man to die but once. After death, you stay there for a period of time to face not judgment. Christianity said they can enter into the bottomless pit and come back alive. That is the teaching from the bottomless pit. That is not the teachings of the royal law. Never. This is the very wizard that gets my enemy polluted with his wicked testimony. And all these things, they are just doing it to initiate people into the graveyards. This is their massive graveyard. As this one also resurrected, he also gave another contradicted testimony. The very wicked one. And said that as soon as he died, according to his lustration, he died. And the angel was now took him to hell also. That every day thousands of people is being cast into the bottomless pit. That when they were bringing white people, this demon that represents angel in his life, The royal law makes it so clear that devil will masquerade himself as an angel of light. This is Christianity, spiritual wickedness in the highest place. This is mystery, people. That the day you are going to see this thing that I'm talking about, you will remember this video wherever you are. This is the mystery. Apostle Shaul said the mystery of iniquity is already at work. This iniquity is a mystery. This their miracle is a mystery, just like the name of Jesus is a mystery. Now, this man has said, as soon as they were throwing white people, the angel never said a word. As soon as they cast in black, some black person, immediately the angel speak up. The devil that he saw as an angel, this is the devil. He speak up and say, this man, while he was on earth, he was a wizard, he was a witch. He always eats people's flesh and drink people's blood. Now that he's here, he's going to be eating his own flesh. Really? What is witchcraft? Witchcraft simply means disobeying, breaking the rules of Yahuwah. Are you not telling me the white people, they are not witch? Because the white people was being cast into there. This demon that said his angel never said nothing. As soon as a black man is brought into the hell, this man began to speak and said this black man was a witch. You see, this is their witchcraft. This is the mystery of iniquity. That demon is manifesting in themselves as an angel of light. And this man said it is true. Now, what happens now? As soon as they die, that is what we are going to look into now. And this man also gave a very wicked testimony that as soon as he was resurrected back to life, the angel told him that the prayer of the rich man in the bottomless pit is be granted unto this generation. How dare you? When Father Yahuwah said a prayer of sinners is an abomination unto him. Father Yahuwah never answered the prayer of abomination or a prayer of a sinner on earth. Now he will go and answer a prayer of a dead sinner right in the bottomless pit that is waiting for his own judgment. Oh, Christianity. Christianity, you have helped to prosper the devil, your father. This is the demon. Now, how is the devil doing these things? All these people that said they died, it is a truth. They all died. They all died. But their spirit is right in the bottomless pit as you and me is talking right now. They know it's using their flesh. It is demon. This Daniel you are seeing here, so it is a high-ranking demon. Demon is a spirit. They need a physical body to operate with. They need human flesh to operate with. And we see this account in Genesis chapter 6, that when demon came, fallen angels, they took upon themselves human flesh, and they now begin to enter into marriage with human being. If demon come to you and say they want to marry you, you will know this is a spirit, because they are spirits. They can't come to you. The only way they can manifest in your life, come to you, they will took upon themselves human flesh. In those days, we see demon, fallen angels, we are married to human beings. They took upon themselves flesh to marry to humans. And Messiah said, as it were, in the days of old, Noah, so it would be at this very present time we are. That demon is going to be taking flesh, taking upon themselves flesh to live with humans. Demon, powerful demon, is already living within us today. All this Daniel, you are seeing this Linda, all this what did they call the Angelica? They are demons. These people died. Their spirit is gone. It's in the bottomless pit. Because when you enter the bottomless pit, you can't come out. Now, who is ministering to us today? It is demon. Demon entered them. Demon took their flesh. Demon is operating now with their flesh. You will still be thinking it is Linda talking. You will still be thinking it is Daniel talking. You will still be thinking it is Angelica. No. Demon is the one talking right now. Teaching another wicked message. This is what Apostle Shaul said. Any angel from heaven, these are the fallen angels from the bottomless pit that took upon themselves now human flesh to deceive us. Listen to the voice of demons right from the pit of hell. Exactly what that witch woman did in clothing a demon with the flesh of a holy prophet. Prophet of Yahuwah. Simon, he now clothed this demon with the flesh of Simon for Saul to be seeing it now that he is seeing Samuel. Meanwhile, he is seeing demons. high-ranking demon from the pit of hell, from the underworld. You see, it's like Father Yehovah, not that it's like Father Yehovah always knew what we are going to be. In my life, by then I was still so very, very young. We encounter a thing like this. Our elder sister died. Normally, by then I was living with my father and my mother separated from my father. When she died, when she come, because she always go to Aswani market and all this large market to buy things and sell in our village every market day. So as soon as she came, come that day, finished selling things, then she now came to the house and to pay us visit. After she have done that, she now returned back to Benin because she was married. On her way, their car, the tire got burst. So my elder sister now just jumped out of the car and uncontrollable used her forehead to hit the tire rod. So therefore, her head not here. She died right away. And she died before they rushed her to hospital. Of course, she gave up the spirit already. So afterwards, they now came to tell us that our sister died. They told our father everybody was in great mourning. We were crying. You know, afterwards, my father buried her. Now, then I was this thing I'm talking about, it happened about 30-something years ago. Now, she has a very best friend. Two of them always go into this business of buying things in Aswani, in Onitsha, and come to our village to sell it. So this very day, this thing happened. This our girlfriend couldn't come with her. That one also have other things doing. She didn't come to our village that day. So she never knew. You know, those days, there was no phone to communicate. There is no communication by phone those days. So this lady, a friend of our elder sister, never knew what happened to her. So after somewhere else, she now also come to our village. Excuse me. Before she come to our village, she went to our Swanee market to buy things. I think maybe weeks or months. I can't remember because by then I was still very, very young. Now when she got to our Swanee, who did she see? She saw my elder sister with a very large tissue on her forehead. So she now asked my sister, what happened? What is this tissue on your head? She now said, my sister, I'm a lucky person, oh. Our car had an accident. Every single person in the car died. Only me alone survived. And this mark you are seeing is where I used to hit the thyroid. So they now stitch it. Really? So this, our sister girlfriend now embraced that. Ah, you are a good head. I never knew. Are you coming to market tomorrow? She now said, no, I'm not going to, because I'm still not yet okay. I'm just being discharged and I'm still not yet okay. You see? So when you go to my village, please extend my greetings to my father, to my mother, to everybody in the family, to my sisters. Tell them that I'm very, very okay. Now, you know, now this lady in the next day, she now came to our village. After finishing selling her things, she now come to our family house and tell us that baby said we should say, she should extend her greetings. My father now said, whoosh, baby, who? She died. She had an accident about some either months ago or weeks ago. She died. He said, who died? Baby died. He said, what are you saying? It is not true. She refused to believe. My father said, she died. We cannot lie anything like that. You see all her younger ones, we were on black, still on black. Until my father had to show this lady where our sister was being buried. It was... In fact, she couldn't handle it. Who do I see then? She saw a demon. A demon took the flesh of her sister to manifest herself to her friend. So this is exactly spirit that is working in Christianity. That all these people died. This Daniel for sure 100% he died, but demon resident. It's this demon that is sharing testimony of bottomless pit. That is why they cannot get it right. That is why they are lying. That is why they are saying when you enter into the bottomless pit, you can still return back. What? Now, why did this thing happen? Father Yehovah let it happen. We see from the royal law, a strong delusion. This is the very strong delusion people, Father Yehovah speaks about. This is the very strong delusion. Because Father Yehovah know already, Christianity is not going to repent. They are the great highlights. They will keep, he said they will persist in their wickedness to keep initiating people into the coven of the devil. They are not going to repent. Therefore, a hot iron has already sealed their heart. So we are doing this message only for the sake of the elect among them. So let's see why Father Yehovah did this. This thing is a strong delusion, not from the devil, but from Father Yehovah himself. Now, like the place I was reading, let me read it again. He said, and with all deceivableness and unrighteousness in them that perish, because they received not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. For this cause, Yehovah shall send them a strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, and that they all might be destroyed, who believed not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. You see, this strong delusion we are seeing are that resurrected Jesus' iniquity, workers of iniquity. It is strong delusion from the Most High himself, because you refuse to abide with the truth of Yahuwah. Shabbat is the sign for all eternity. You reject it, therefore get a lie. Only one name is given whereby you must be saved. You reject it, therefore get a lie. All the feast is for all eternity. You refuse it, therefore get a lie. The name of Yahuwah is just one. You refuse it, therefore get a lie. So this is what is going on here. This is exactly what is going on here. Let's see how Father Yahuwah is doing this. How he sending down this strong delusion. First King chapter 22. This was in the case of Ahab, who refused to obey the holy things of Yahuwah. And Father Yohanan sent to him a lying spirit to deceive him so that he would be destroyed. Now he said, First King, for I read from verses 19 to where? No, I read from verses 22, I think so. Okay. I read from 20. And Yehovah said, who shall persuade Ahab that he may go up and fall at the Philistine? And one said unto this manner, one said on this manner, and other said on this manner. And there come forth a lying spirit, and stood in the presence of Yahuwah, and said, I will persuade Ahab. And Father Yahuwah said unto him, wherewith? And he said, I will go forth and be a lying spirit in the mouth of all his prophets. And he said, thou shalt proceed, persuade him, and prevail also. Go forth and do just that. Now, therefore, behold, Yahuwah has put a lying spirit in the mouth of all those thy prophet, and Yahuwah has spoken evil concerning thee these days. You see, it is from Yahuwah himself. This is the strong delusion, because you refuse to hold on to receive the truth. Therefore, believe a lie. Take a lie and live by the lies. So this is being done by Yahuwah himself, not by nobody, not by devil. It is a strong delusion from Yahuwah. Because your case is already being settled, you are going to be destroyed for all eternity. You will never come out until you be cast into the lake of fire. Now let's see when Ahab, Samuel rebelled against Yahuwah, what happened? He said, but the spirit of Yahuwah departed from Saul. Excuse me, Saul, not Samuel. And an evil spirit from Yahuwah troubled him. And Saul's servant said unto him, behold, now an evil spirit from Yahuwah troubled thee. You see? An evil spirit from Yahuwah troubled thee. This is the evil spirit that is troubling Christianity today. Do you say the evil spirit is troubling? Then let's take a look a little bit. There is so much more to talk about in this. But for the sake of time, do you see how the evil spirit is troubling them? I'm not showing this man because it's the worst. No. I'm just showing it for you to see how the evil spirit is troubling you these days. Eat snake, drink fuel, go and eat grass. Pastor Harvey says with a sister pastor's wife.
Okay, you see?
This is how the evil spirit is troubling you today.
Let's come back.
Now they will go to the field and eat grass. You see, this is how the evil spirit is troubling you. You see, you working so hard, giving your money to your pastors. That is the trouble. This is the strong delusion, people, of I die, I resurrected. This is Christianity, spiritual witchcraft, and physical witchcraft. You see, there is so much to talk about this. Maybe I'm going to do another video, not too long, just to conclude this message, if Yahuwah's will. There are so much more to talk about. This is their witchcraft. This is their witchcraft, people. You see? They will hypnotize them. You see, now she's going to drink fuel. So this is it. And this thing came from Yehovah. This is the strong delusion. Why? Because you refuse to take the holy things of Yehovah.
How does it taste like?
Oh, Yazreel, this message is being done for your sake.
Is it sweet?
Come out of there, Father Yehovah is saying. If Yehovah's will, we will complete the other side. I want to show you more video of
it?
The pastor that said he can make a male penis, a bishop that said he can enlarge male penis. You see what this bishop is doing? He is praying to enlarge this male penis to make it fat, to make it big. You see, he will hold the penis. You see the work of iniquity. This is Mahud. Let me take it closer so that you see what I'm seeing here. You see? He's massaging a male penis like him. He said he wants to make it big. You see the iniquity. Not that these people are the worst, but they are just some of them.